Last class we discussed about Bayesian error rate and the characteristics of Navy Bayes classifier. Okay, in this session we are going to discuss the last topic in our fourth unit called Bayesian belief networks. See, already in last class we discussed that if there are two or more attributes which are correlated to each other, means Navy Bayesian classifier would not be performed better. Okay, so that we have to identify with a parameter called as error of Bayes theorem or Bayes. Okay, so we identify with a common value called as a particular what we call as Gaussian distribution, and with a standard deviation we have to calculate particular parameter. Okay, based on this we have to assume our boundary. So the boundary, based upon the boundaries we are calculated Bayes error rate. Okay, so but when you come to Bayesian belief networks, it is completely purely used when there is two or more attributes are correlated to each other. In order to use Bayes theorem or Navy Bayes classifier, we use Bayesian belief networks. So Bayesian belief networks are the particular procedure or a particular method which is used to identify if there are two or more attributes are correlated to each other. Okay, see, coming to this session, Bayesian belief networks. So the conditional assumption made by Navy Bayes classifier may not be useful, especially for classification problems in which the attributes are somewhat correlated. Now we are going to discuss about a more flexible approach for modeling the class conditional probabilities, as like as P of for a given class label we are identifying or finding what we call as attributes. Okay, see, this model representation is simple, so simple. It has two properties. First one is you have to construct a particular what we call as directed acyclic graph, and second one, based upon this directed acyclic graph we have to construct a probability table for associating each node. Okay, so the Bayesian belief networks are simply Bayesian networks. It provides a graphical representation of probabilistic relations. So this is represented graphically using probabilistic relations among set of random variables. So for this representation there are two key elements. First one is a directed acyclic graph. Okay, as you know that a directed acyclic graph is used in particular data structures or software engineering or STM. We use some graph representation encoding how you use this DAG, means the dependence relationship among the set of variables. By means of constructing or representing the DAG, we have to associate the DAG with the probability table associating each node to its immediate parent nodes. So we have to identify who is the parent nodes, who is the child node, who is the ancestor, and who is the descendant. So all can be identified by means of this particular representation of graph. Okay, so consider we have three random variables A, B, C, in which A and B are independent variables. Okay, so we have A, B, C attributes. Follow A, B, C attributes. A and B are independent variables, or P and B are independent attributes, but and each has a direct influence on third variable C. For example, if A and B, C are three independent variables, but random variables, three are different variables. Among three, these two are independent, but any one have the dependent on particular third one. Whether it is A, B are independent, means A to C are dependent, or B to C are dependent. Okay, the relation among the variables can be summarized into the directed acyclic graph as shown in the figure. How you can represent it? You can be represented. So each node in a graph represents variables and each earth asserts the dependency relationship between the pair of variables. So if you take a particular node, in that node in a graph represent a variable, that is nothing but an attribute. Okay, and each arc asserts the dependence relation between the pair of variables. If there is a directed arc from x to y, then x is the parent and y is the child. Okay, furthermore, you have to implement in a network that x to z and x is an ancestor of z, or z is a descendant of x. See, for example, this one. If you see this one, see A and B are parent to C. Already we discussed that, and C is a, what we call as, if C is a descendant to A and C is a descendant to B. So, and for you go for this example, A is a descendant of A is a descendant of D, whereas D is an ancestor of both A and B. D is an ancestor of B. Both B and D also non-descendants of A, because this is an ancestor, means these two are independent to this one. Okay, as shown in figure C, Y is a class, target class, and these are the attribute set. So by means of this target class, we are deriving, that is, these are the childs and this is the parent. So this is an ancestor and this is a descendant. Okay, so the probability condition, why, what is the conditional independence in this particular Bayesian belief network, means a node in a Bayesian network is conditionally independent of its non-descendants. So non-descendants means like this. This is a non-descendants. So this is conditionally independent to non-descendants if the parents are known. If the parents are known, D is known to A and B, so that these two are conditionally independent. Okay. Besides the conditional independent condition imposed by network topology, each node is also associated with a probability table. How you construct the probability table? Now you construct the particular table called particular graph using DAG, and now you are constructing table. How means, if a node X, this is the node X, does not have any parents. So this is a B, this is a parent, this is a particular node which doesn't have any parents, then the table contains only prior probability, only one probability called as P of X. Okay, if only this means there is no particular parent, means it is the P of X. Okay, or P of P, this is the P of P. If a node has only one parent Y, consider this AC. If a node has only one parent called as A, then the table contains a conditional probability, what we called as P of X by Y, that is, we called as C by A. If node has only one parent Y, C to A, so that we can treat as P of C by A. Okay. If a node has multiple parents like this, if a node has multiple parents, 1, 2, okay, then we can assume that X by C1, D1, okay, C, comma, D. Okay. So this is the right. How you can construct this table? Okay. For example, see, we have a patient for modeling patients with heart disease or heart one problems as shown in below figure. See, basically, each variable in the diagram is assumed to be a binary value. We are assuming that each and every, for an example, yes or no, diet, yes or no, blood pressure, yes or no, chest pain, yes or no, we have the class labels heart disease and heart one. Okay, so the patient notes for heart disease HD correspond to risk factors that may affect the disease, such as exercise E and D, diet D. So this is the node, this is a particular node, this node is dependent on exercise and diet, so that this can be constructed with the parent node called as exercise and diet. Okay, the child nodes for heart disease correspond to symptoms of disease such as chest pain and high blood pressure, so that whenever there is affected by heart disease, exercise and diet, the resultant the childs are blood pressure and chest pain. Okay, and for example, diagram shows a heartburn may result from an unhealthy diet and may lead to chest pain. If it is diet, then it is go to heart disease. If it is unhealthy means, then it is go to heartburn. It leads to chest pain. So that by the whatever the given data, we constructed what are called as Bayesian belief networks. Okay. So for each and every data, they're given some data. If it is exercise is doing, okay, 0.7. If he is in a healthy diet maintaining, so that it is a 0.25. So when you are doing healthy means 2.4 means unhealthy is a 0.75. You are doing exercise means you are not doing exercise, then it is a 30, 0. Okay, right. Consider if he is maintaining probability, he is maintaining S. Okay, if he is maintaining exercise and diet is following, so that the heart disease ratio is very low, 0.25. If he is doing exercise but not taking unhealthy means, it is 0.45. He is not doing exercise but taking a healthy food means 0.55. The ratio of coming, there is a possibility of heart disease. If there is no doing exercise, if he is not doing healthy food, so there is a lead to 0.75. Okay, this is the construction of the table from the given the data. Which is not given, we consider this as an example. Okay, so this is the given data. If he is doing heartburn, that is he is doing healthy diet, so that the healthy diet is 0.2. If he is not doing healthy diet, though, so that it leads to unhealthy, that is 0.85. okay, point clear, right? 8.0. okay, so the heartburn cannot be constructed because with the help of chest exercise, because already he mentioned that the heartburn may result from a unhealthy diet, not based on the exercise. Okay, right. If it is diet, he is maintaining diet, and but he is sometimes, if he is not doing taking unhealthy food means, it becomes chest pain. By means of chest pain, we have the following features, that is heart disease and heartburn. Both means, for example, the chest pain will be 0.8. If this is a heart disease, there is no particular heartburn, the resultant is 0.6. If it is heart disease and heartburn, it is 0.4. And if it is heart disease, no. Heartburn is no. Okay. So the chest pain will be very low. Okay. The chest pain for heart disease and heartburn. Okay. Whereas if you take the blood pressure, there is no particular heartburn. It is only for heart disease. So for a BP is high, if heart disease is S, this is 0.25. If there is no heart disease means 0.2. Okay. This is the given data. What already this data is defaultly given by particular data. Okay. Now the nodes associated with the risk factors contains only the prior probabilities, whereas the nodes for heart disease, heartburn, and the corresponding symptoms contains the conditional probabilities. This is the conditional probability. This is the conditional probability. Okay. Right. To save space, some of the probabilities have been omitted from the diagram. See, that is how it is omitted means, see, if we are not calculating heart disease of no case, we are calculating only heart disease of S case, heartburn of S case, blood pressure of I case, chest pains for S case. There is no particular no cases are not constructed. If we want to construct a no case, if you take particular feature, particular conditional probability, and implement using 1 minus P of conditional probability. For example, see, if it is a heart disease with a feature of health, exercise is unhealthy, 0.45. Now, if you calculate heart disease of no with a exercise is and diet is unhealthy means 1 minus what you get the data. Okay, you are calculating heart disease no with these two parameters, so that 1 minus 0.55. 1 minus 0.55. Then you get what the value, 0.45. For heart disease no. For heart disease no, this value is 0.45. Similarly, we have to construct all these values. Okay, right. This is the particular concept. How you model the building means it is using the two-step process. First, you have to construct the DAG and estimate the probability values in tables for each node. So that the network topology can be obtained by encoding the subjective knowledge of domain experts. And the below we have to this can be constructed with an algorithm. This one, like T of, we have various 1, 2, 3 so on variables like this. These are the variables 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 variables. For j equal to 1, 2, 2, if you are calculating for with this one, 1, 2, 2, we are calculating this one. Okay, let xt of g denote the jth highest order of variable t. We are constructing, this is the order of highest order of t. Okay, next, let pi of xtj, you are calculating with the help of this one. This one, you are calculating with the help of 0.5. You are calculating with the help of what conditional probability. Okay, now we are calculating pi of xt of j, that is xt of 1, xt of 2, xt of j minus 1. Calculating this one, xt of 1, xt of 2, xt of 3, so on, xt of j1. Okay, now after calculating each value, remove the variables from pi of x to j that do not affect xj. So that if you are calculating with the blood pressure means you are taking exercise, diet, ethnicities, the blood pressure will come with the capability of with highest values, not this value. If you are taking this exercises D equal to LT, heart disease is a less probability, so that you are removing this one. You are considering only these two features. You are removing these two features like that. Remove the variables from pi of xtj that do not affect xj. Create an arc between xt of j and remaining variables in pi of xt of j. Now you have to arc these two features remaining with this one feature. So that we construct this particular what we called as Bayesian belief networks. So that we completed this unit with minor any doubts. Whatever you doubts you have, see, so just ping me. So that we complete this unit. In next week we complete, we start and complete 5th unit. Most probably within 2 weeks we complete data warehousing and data mining subject. Okay, thank you all.